Good morning. My name is Mike, and this is the ThinkPad X1 Carbon i5-6300. Look at how thin that is. So thin. Such a great machine. I'm basically in love with this machine, and I'm going to hate to get rid of it. I paid a couple hundred bucks for it, Canadian. I got a pretty good deal because of the screen. It has some imperfections. We'll touch on those later, but yeah, it's a little scuffed in the top, too. You can see it right there. It's not perfect. But, you know, we're not here to do perfect. We're here to find something that will work for you. I'd highly recommend this. So light and thin. I wouldn't call it a gaming machine, per se. But if you're into, you know, Facebooking, is that really a thing? Doing Wordle. You know, spreadsheets, writing. Such a comfortable keyboard. You cannot go wrong with this keyboard. This is the machine for you. This is more of your dad's laptop than your laptop. Unless you're a dad, then this is your laptop. All right, let's do a quick walk around on it. Okay, and here we are. Like I said, it's a little scuffed up, a little bit scratched, but not the end of the world. So thin. Look at how thin that is. I'll put a Sharpie here for comparison. It's basically the same thickness as a Sharpie. Now, there is ventilation down here in the bottom. Serial number, Windows 8. Pro, I believe that is. Maybe it's Windows 10, but hard to say. Speaker, four rubber feet, right here and here and here. And I believe this particular model has a fingerprint reader and this trackpad. Not a bad trackpad, better than the Lenovo ThinkPad T440 or X240, because at least you got the buttons here as well as the nipple. But, yeah, you know, not perfect. All right, let's start on this side. So we have power supply. We have their really weird docking system. That is a display port. This here is a high-speed USB-A. And you'll see it also has a little battery on there. So that means that you can also charge it when, well, charge something that's plugged into it when this is off. On the front, we have a whole lot of nothing. On this side over here, we have a combination headphone microphone jack. We have another high-speed USB-A port and yet another high-speed USB-A port and a full-size HDMI complemented by this lock. I can't tell if that's a Noble lock or a Kensington lock. On the back, we have some ventilation with this fan here. Got a hinge. And then under here, this is where things get a little wacky. I wouldn't say that's easy to use. But you do have a slot for a micro SD card and a SIM card. So you can see it right there. Micro SD and a SIM card slot right there. That thing, not exactly easy to access. And nothing on top. The keyboard itself, though, really comfy. That's a full-size keyboard there. I've been using it quite often, and you know what I like is the enter key, for example. It's not one of those machines that I'm accidentally hitting enter. You know, I find it really comfortable for typing. Everything you need is right here. No touch bars, no silly add-ons, nothing that's going to break. All right, let's see how fast this will turn on. Okay, we'll put a clock up here. And we are now going to hit the power button in 3, 2, 1, push. You can see the keyboard lights up. You can light up the keyboard by holding down the function and the space key. That activates like the think light. I forget if it makes any startup sounds. I turned off the password though, so it should go right into the OS and that'll give us a rough time in the boot. Okay, that's the Zorin logo right there. Zorin. And there we are. Now, everything is connecting down here. It looks like the Wi-Fi is already connected. Bluetooth. Oh, and did I mention that the battery is freaking awesome? Okay, so it's up and running, good to go. Let's take a quick look at that battery. Now, it's plugged in. I'll unplug it. So, 85% and about 4 hours to go. That is an all-day battery. Okay, and now for the part you've all been waiting for. Dissection. Let's see what's inside this. As always, I recommend buying a good screwdriver set just for computers. And we will need a Phillips head, something nice and small. This is a PH100. And I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I guess that's it. 9 screws. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Anything under here? Nope, no surprises. Okay, let's start with that. Okay, so it looks like the screws have those backings on them, which means that the screws won't fall out, hopefully. Which should mean I do not need my screw tray. Okay, I believe it's loose. Uh-oh. I just popped it open and this came off the back. That looks like a plastic clip. Don't know where that came from. Okay, so hopefully I didn't break anything. Yeah, see how the screws are held in with these little washers? Kind of a carbon, not carbon, you know, not metal, not plastic. Closer to metal than plastic, but something in between. And here we are, inside the X1 carbon. It looks like it's 50% battery. What else do we have here? We have a CMOS battery. We have, anything interesting? This is probably your Wi-Fi card under there. Yeah, that's your Wi-Fi card. Oh, that's your solid state drive right there. .256 GB. Okay, and the RAM is probably right under here. Or it's soldered on, hard to tell. Yeah, I think it's soldered on. Or it's underneath the battery. How's that battery held in? So here's the speaker and there's the speaker. You know, I wouldn't say it's gonna run too hot. That's the i5 cooling thing. This is your processor underneath this fan. I don't wanna mess around with it too much, but at least you can upgrade the hard drive because that's it right there. Easy peasy. So like I said, I can't seem to find the RAM unless it's on the other side. I don't wanna dig too deep into this. And what are these off of? Maybe that's part of the SIM card tray, because here is the micro SD card slot, and that's a SIM card tray. And like I said, that's that funky looking docking station they have. But yeah, they have these special docking stations that plug into here. And then I think it's called the ThinkPad One Dock, or One Pad or something, or One Dock. And that allows you to hook a lot of other things up to it as well. Okay, hopefully that gives you a good view on it. Now for the fun part of putting it all back together. Okay, that should be it. So if you look right there closely, you'll see how it says 4th gen right there. All right, let's test it, that webcam it has. Before we do that though, let's take a quick look at the power supply here. As you can see, it is just a small little power supply. Don't lose this cable, whatever you do. 20 volt, 2 point something amp. Oh, there it is, 2.25 amp. And you'll see the part number on it right there. The FRU, which is basically what IBM calls their part numbers. And it is 00HM625. Little tiny power supply, because it's, you know, a little tiny computer. Now I do find this is a little bit quiet. Even with the volume turned all the way up, I'm having trouble hearing it. If we go into YouTube really quickly, let's see how the volume sounds when I turn it up. Oh yeah, have you checked out my other channel yet?
Good morning. My name is Mike. This is my very first video for this channel. I have
doesn't sound too bad.
Channels, so I've hundreds of videos and millions of views, everything else. This is the C64 Mini, and my goal with this channel is to make Commodore 64 long play videos.
All right, there we go.
I love the C64 Mini. It's funny because growing up, I never had a Commodore 64.
Yeah, that didn't sound too bad. A little tinny. All right, let's find the camera. All right. Not too bad. Doesn't help I get this big box light right above me here. I think that's acceptable. That's the photo, video. Let's see if we can find settings in here. Oh, effects. You can never go wrong with the effects. Historical, dice, kung fu, Hulk. What do you think? Think this is the right channel, or think this is the right color for us? I don't know. Have to turn that effect off. Preferences. Image capture. So photo resolution is 960 by 540. Video resolution, 960. Oh, you can go 1280 by 720. We can change this 1280 to 720. And that makes it a little bit brighter. No complaints with that. Okay. Yeah, it's not bad. Needs a little bit of image stabilization. Stabilization, if you know what I mean. Holy crap, that's horrible. Okay, so final thoughts on the ThinkPad X1. That's, like I said, fourth gen. It works well with Zorin. It works well with Ubuntu. That's a no-brainer. I would highly suggest either one of these OSs. They have everything you possibly need, including a full office suite. So there's nothing stopping you from installing Zorin or Ubuntu on this machine. It would seem that everything works. Now, the machine itself, this computer, like I said, I paid around $200 Canadian. That was taxes and everything in, including the charger. And it came with 8 gigs of RAM and a 256 gig SSD. There was no OS installed, but it does have these minor issues in the screen. Like I said, it looks like there's 1, 2, 3 pressure marks and a slight scratch. I can live with that. Some people can't. It does have HDMI out. You can get the docking station for it. You can plug in an external monitor, plus a display port. So that should not be a brainer, like a no-brainer. They do sell, when I look here, anywhere from, here's 150 with no hard drive, no OS, and that's the i7. 240, that's the i5, no hard drive. 260, here's one 420, but that's a 512 gig SSD with 16 gigs of RAM and the i7. So that's a bit of a powerhouse. I think if you find this for under, you know, between $250 to $300, you're ahead of the game. And like I said, it's a really comfortable keyboard. It's a really light machine. I do like the fingerprint reader. It has everything you need. Fantastic machine. This would be, if I was looking at a level of them with this being low end and this being high end, I'd put it, you know, right smack dab in the middle. It's a competent machine. You won't be playing games on it, but you can get homework done, and it's a fantastic machine just to sit there and get all of your thoughts down on the keyboard. Okay, that's all I have to say. If you do like these kind of videos, leave a thumbs up. If you don't like these kind of videos, leave a comment, because I'm always curious to see why people don't like these videos, because I think they're awesome. And if you're new to the channel, well, thanks for stopping by. This is what my typical video looks like. This is what I typically review. Next week, though, I might be talking about this 3DS. Just because I really do dig these. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hit that like button. We'll talk soon.